describe being locked up just for a second, man.
Locked up, bro? Shit.
How long you was down?
Man, at that time, about 15 months, 14 to 15 months.
So a year and some change.
Yeah, a year and some change, man, you know?
Yeah.
At that time, nigga went through a lot of, you know what I mean? You gotta go through the trials and tribulations in that motherfucker.
Shit, did you breathe through that bitch? Was it love?
Hell
was
no,
it
hate? I didn't breathe through that shit. I mean, you're gonna breathe through it no matter what, but it's like, not really breathe through, but you're gonna go through the processes. It's just like, the mental, you know what I mean, the mental psychology part of it, you feel me? Like, yeah, dealing with depression, dealing with, like, you feel me? You know, you think about family, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's more than, I mean, you don't got no pussy, you know what I mean? you know what I mean? You're not
a whole year without some pussy when you know you could get some.
Man. But I figured out, because, you know what I mean, right now I'm reading about some shit called, semen retention and, so use, instead of, like, you know what I mean? Like, you use that energy that you would have used when you aroused and use that towards your goals, you feel me?
Right.
So at that time, that's what I was doing in prison, but I didn't realize that. Because
right.
You don't got no motherfucking choice, you feel me?
Right.
So that's why I started working out.
Right.
You know what I mean? Trying to beat the depression because, like, you in there, you thinking all this shit, you just suck up.
Oh,
you losing weight, you feel me? I'm in there 140 pounds, you feel me? Looking crazy. So.
Yeah.
A little bit, you be like, man, fuck this.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna come out like this, nigga. I ain't gonna let the time do me. I'm at least come out looking good, nigga. I didn't. You start thinking different, so.
I feel like a lot of people, like, get locked up, and then they get, you know what I'm saying? They be like, I feel like a lot of people, like, Gucci. Remember when Gucci got locked up? That nigga was fat as hell.
Yeah.
Nigga came out of jail.
I'm telling you, trials and tribulations. he went through his trials and tribulations. He in there thinking like, bro, I can't come out looking fat as hell.
Yeah,
I come out looking a little buff. You feel me? At least I spend the time doing something. You know what I mean? Productive. You feel me? Instead of just you in there, you watching TV or you calling people, and then you get locked back in your fucking cell. You dealing with this motherfucker. Your cellie might be a fiend. Next door might be a fiend. You don't know what the fuck they thinking.
Yeah,
niggas is woofing for no reason over some bullshit.
For sure, man.
Like, you know what I mean? Like, so it's like, what you gonna do, man?
Right.
I might get some money. I might get some push ups in, get some pull ups in. You feel me?
I remember being locked up, man. Like, what's the worst thing about jail to you?
The worst thing about jail to me?
Yeah. Besides, man, not getting no pussy, like, why you in there?
Besides not getting some money, man, the worst thing is that you realize that the fast money ain't worth it.
Right.
Because if you really think about it, it's like, man, I was out for this long, but then I'm sitting down for this long. Like, if I average zero here, zero money coming in,
right,
and you average it with that one coming in, it's like, bro, you were just better off.
In your mind.
What the fuck I'm doing this shit for?
Yeah.
Like, you can't put the money in a bank. You feel me? You can't borrow no based on the money you made. You can't go to somebody and say, you can't lend no money from somebody.
Right.
So what the fuck? All this shit is like, I'm playing the wrong game. And that's when I realized, in prison, I realized I was playing the wrong game. And it took, one of the homeboys just reading a book for me to realize that I was playing the wrong game. And he got the book sent in from one of his uncles or one of his aunties.
Where?
That's how I... Because at the time when I'm in prison, you got to think, I just had a kid, you feel me?
Right.
Like, I had a son, and, like, you know what I mean, he's 4 months old, and I'm thinking then, I'm like, I can't leave still playing the same game that I came in with.
Right.
Because the next time, now, if I do get jammed up again, it ain't going to be no more 1.5 years you leave out of prison.
Is that when I seen you, and then when you was like, yo, I ain't smoking no more? Is that when?
Yeah.
I remember me and you was down at the little joint on Liz, at the end of Lisbon Street.
Okay.
Remember we was there early in the morning one time. I said, hey, yo, what's up?
Yeah.
That nigga was gone. And he was like, yo, let me get that. And she said, yo, this is what we got. That nigga said, let me get that.
Yeah.
You remember that shit, right?
Yeah.
He was hanging for it. Man. Look, nigga, how many? That was a year ago.
That was about a year ago.
A year or two. Year or two.
Because at that time, I was going through the, like, you know what I mean, the self-development. So at the time, I'm still thinking, like, weed is going to affect me. Like, I got to, basically, for me to change how I was before, I had to literally stop doing anything I was doing.
Right.
And I can't still hang around with the same people and do the same things and try to build a new life. So what happened is, through that progress, I ended up finding myself where now I can control everything. So that's why I ended up going back there. So I can smoke weed and still not affect me, still be up 7 in the morning and still get to my job.
Yeah.
And then, but I work for myself. I own my own business.
So what you doing? Tell me about it.
So I own a cleaning business, right? It's called AXOUSTIC.
Okay.
And we clean kitchen exhaust systems.
Yeah.
You know, and we also do professional, like, office cleaning. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I also own a men's skincare line.
Wow. What's the name of it?
It's called Zane.
Really?
Yeah, and I named it after my son. You know, my son's name is Zane, the oldest one.
Okay.
And he was the one I was 4 months when I was locked up. You feel me? And I remember when I was locked up, I was in my cell and I was reading a newspaper.
Yeah.
Because the newspaper in jail is like, it's like TV, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
For us in there, because you don't got nothing else to really catch up on the outside. You know what I mean? So. All that playing behind the mix with me would be